So I recently posted this comment on this meme, and it resulted in these. My comment was on how I use Microsoft Power Automate to automatically download any email attachment I receive and add the sender's email address and the email subject line to the file name upon it saving. So for example, if Bill Gates were to send me an email with the subject line "You rock" and a file attachment with the name letterofrecommendation.pdf, I would have a file automatically appear in my email attachments folder named bill@microsoft.com-you-rock-letterofrecommendation.pdf. On top of that, Bill's email would automatically get listed in a spreadsheet with a timestamp and those same data points, just as one more place to easily search past emails, and as a way for me to conduct any sort of data analysis on the trends of my inbox whenever I feel like it. So since you asked, this is how I set this up. For this process, you will need Microsoft Power Automate. Head over to make.powerautomate.com and click on templates. From the templates page, search for save email attachments. Notice there are several variations of this process already templated out to work with Gmail and Google Drive and Dropbox. For this example, we'll be staying within the Microsoft 365 Enterprise ecosystem, saving Outlook email attachments to OneDrive for Business. After you click on the template, you'll quickly ensure that you've authenticated your credentials for both platforms and hit continue. Now, if all you want to do is save the attachments, then you're all set. This flow template works right out of the box. But let's make things a little more interesting by diving into the inner workings here. By clicking Edit, we can start refining the process. If you'd like, you can place any filters you'd like on the email trigger, like limiting it to a specific folder in your inbox or even a specific sender. I'm gonna leave it set to all emails. The action is where we're gonna make changes. As I expand this section, you can see how the flow is selecting the attachment from the previous step and creating the file. By default, it'll save those files in a folder named Email Attachments from Power Automate. That'll be located in the root of your OneDrive folder, but you can easily navigate to any existing folder synced with your OneDrive account. To make things more easily searchable, I'm simply gonna edit the file name field and plug in the sender's email using from and the email subject using subject. Then I'll add my hyphens. This particular template actually has a built-in failsafe. By expanding the conditions section, you can see that there's an action that only runs if status 409 is returned. Now, according to Microsoft support, error code 409 occurs when there's a process conflict. By having this condition, the flow will essentially wait a few seconds and then try again if there's an error. So what we have to do is make those same file name changes within the Create File Retry section. Once you've done that, the first piece of the process is complete. Now to create the spreadsheet tracker, let's take a bit of a detour and jump into Excel. In our blank spreadsheet, we'll begin labeling our headers, received time, from, to, CC, subject, and attachment. Select format as table, making sure that my table has headers is selected, and then we'll save our spreadsheet in a folder that's also synced with OneDrive. Hopping back over to our Power Automate flow, click the plus sign between the two steps and add a parallel branch. Select Excel Online, and your action will be to add a row into a table. Select your OneDrive account and find the Excel file we just saved, and then select the table we just made in that file. Then we get to mapping using receive time, from, to, CC, subject, and attachment's name. Then all you need to do is click save and make sure it's turned on. Use your flow checker to make sure that nothing was overlooked, and then hit test for a final check. Now your Power Automate flow is in place and you're on your document management A-game. Per Mr. Gates' email and the attachment on 12/27, I rock.